Hello students, welcome in one another lecture of subject Highway Engineering. In the last lecture, we had discussed the unit number 1, that is overview to Highway Engineering. In that lecture, we had discussed the some general terms regarding to the highway and the classification of highways, that is the overview of highway. Then, now in this lecture, we are going to discuss the chapter number 2 or unit number 2, that is the geometric design of highways. This unit is comes for 16 marks. Now see what is the geometric design of highway. Geometric design means while constructing the highways or before constructing the highways, we had to design its different elements. It is called as a geometric design of highways. Now we can start this unit number 2, that is geometric design of highways. Now see, first point in this chapter is the definition of geometric design. Now see what is the geometric design. The phase of highway design which deals with the feasible elements of different highways such as the alignment, side distance, etc. is called a geometric design of highways. Now see what is a geometric design. It is a one phase of highway design in which we can design the feasible elements of highways, that is the elements of highway we can easily feasible with eyes. These elements are designed in geometric design of highway, such as the side distance or alignments of road. In order to provide speed, safety and comfort to the road users, proper geometric design of road is must before its construction. To provide the speed, then safety to the road users and comfort to the road users, the proper geometric design of road is important before its construction. Now the next point is, the following points should be kept in view while doing the geometric design of highways. That is, while doing the geometric design of highways, we must remember the following point. The alignment should be economical. First point is, the alignment should be economical. While doing the design of alignment of roads, keep remember the alignment should be economical. Then second point is, the gradient must be easy and suitable. The gradient of road is must be easy and suitable. Then third is, on straight road provide adequate chamber. On the straight roads or the roads which does not have any turn, for that road provide adequate chamber. Curves provided must be smooth and easy. At the same time, sufficient side distance must be available on curve. That is, when any turn or any curve is provided to the road, this curve is smooth and easy at same time, and this curve has the sufficient side distance. Keep each and every record of field work. While designing the geometric parameters of highways, keep the record of field work of actual site. Proper road sign must be provided. In the geometric design, the proper road signs must be provided at roads. Hope you all get these points. These points are kept in mind while designing the geometric parameters or while geometric design of the highways. Now see, in this point we have some words like alignment, then gradient, then chamber, then curves or curves. These words are new for you all. Now in this lecture, we are going to see what is these elements of the roads. Now, important highway terms. In these important highway terms, we are going to discuss the words like this, chamber or alignment or gradient. We all get the concept of this in this point. Next point is important highway terms. In that, first is right of way. First important term of highway is right of way. Now, what is the definition of right of way? What is meaning of right of way? The area of the land acquired for construction and development of road along its alignment is known as a right of way. It is of right of way. The area of land acquired for construction and development of road along its alignment is known as a right of way. What is the meaning of right of way? The total area which can be required for the construction of road, that is the total area including the full road, its right of way. The width of this acquired land is known as the land width. The total width of these roads or the land which can be used for roads is known as the land width. Now we can see the right of way distance for all roads. For national and state highways, the open areas, that is a normal or range, that is total area. Then built up area, that is the total area in which road is get constructed. Then in, it is for plain and rolling terrain. Then for mountain and steep terrain, that is in hilly roads, open area and built up area. Now see, for national and state highways, in plain roads the normal range, normal area is 45, then range is 30 to 60, then built up area is 30 and range is 30 to 60. Then for mountain or hilly area, it is a 24 to 20. Then for major district road, it is a 25 to 30, then built up area is 20 or the in range 50 to 25. Then for hilly roads, it is a 18 and 50. Now second is major district roads. For major district roads, the open area is 25 and in range 25 to 30. Now see, what is the meaning of range? Normal means the normal area of roads, and range means in between this range, that is the normal area for major district roads is 25 for plain and rolling terrain, that is for plain surface. The normal open area for major district road is 25 and is maybe in range of 25 to 30. It should be allowed in range of 25 to 30, that is the area must be, it is a 26 27 28 29 and up to 30, that is the, it is the range of the roads. Now built up area is 20 and range of built up area is 50 to 25. Then in mountain or in steep terrain, the range, sorry, the area is for major district road is 80 and built up area is 50. Now for other district roads, the normal open area is 50 and range is 50 to 25, for and built up area is 50 and range of built up area is 50 to 20. For the mountain, the open area is 50 and buildable area is 12. For village road, for plain village roads, the open area is 12 and range is between 12 to 18. Buildable area is 10 and range of buildable area is between 10 to 15. And the for mountain and steep terrain, the open area is for village road is 9 and built-up area is also 9. Hope you get the right way, that is the area of roads. Now see, for national and state highways, for mountain and steep terrain, the open area is 24 and built-up area is 20. Then next point is factors which are considering for that right away distance or the for the area of roads. First is the category of highway and width of roadway and road margins. For calculating the area of road, or right away distance, first factor is the category of highway and width of roadway and road margins. That is, while calculating the road area, we first remember the category of highway or the what is the category of that road, then what is the width of road and what is the road margin. Then second is height of embankment or depth of cutting. What is the height of embankment of that road and what is the depth of cutting? Embankment means the area or distance of or the road is constructed on raised surface, filling with the soil and sufficiently compacted. That is the length of surface which can be filled with materials, it is a embankment. Then next factor is drainage system and its size. Then next is side distance, consideration on horizontal curve. And next is reservoir land for future winding. This is the factors which can be get in or remember while calculating the roadway width. Then next term is road margin. Now see the definition of road margin. What is the road margin? The portion of land width on either side of roadways of a road are known as a road margin. That is the portion or area on the both sides of road is called as a road margins. The various elements included in the road margins are shoulders, parking lane, frontage road, driveway, cycle track, footpath, guardrail and embankment slope. That is the elements which will be included in road margin is shoulders, parking lane or the area which can be provided for parking, then frontage roads, then driveway, then track for cycle or footpath or guard rail and embankment slope. The minimum shoulder width recommended by IRC is 2.5 meter. That is the minimum shoulder width for road margins is recommended by Indian Road Congress is 2.5 meter. Now, after road margins, the next term is roadway width. Now see the definition of roadway width. The top width of a high embankment or bottom width of high cutting excluding the side drains is called as a roadway width or formation width. That is a total width of roads excluding its side drains or the width of highway cutting or width of high embankment is called as a roadway width. Now we can see the roadway width in meter for various roads. For national and state highways, the highways in plain and rolling terrain having the roadway width for single lane 12 meter, for two lane it is also 12 meter. Or the highways or state, national or state highways which is in mountain or steep terrain, the roadway width is 6.25 meter or 8.80 meter. Then for major district roads, for single lane it is a 9 meter, for two lane it is also 9 meter, and in mountains for single lane it is a 4.75. Then other district roads, for single lane it is a 7.5 meter, for two lanes it is a 9 meter, and in mountain it is a 7.5 meter for single lane roads. In mountain there is a no two lane roads. Now village roads, single lane village roads are, all village roads are single lane roads. It is a 7.5 meter in plain areas, and in mountains it is a 4 meter. Now next is carriage way. Next term is carriage way. The portion of roadway constructed for movement of vehicular traffic is called as a carriage way pavement or crust. The portion of roadways constructed for movement of vehicular traffic is called as a carriage way pavement or crust. Now we can see the width of carriage ways for different roads. For single lane it is a 3.75 meter, for two lane without raised up curbs it is a 7 meter, for two lane with raised up curbs it is a 7.2 meter, for immediate carriage way it is a 5.5 meter, and multi lane pavement it is a 3.5 meter per lane. That is a, it is the distance of carriage way. Now we revise again these four points. That is, now see, we can start, or we had seen the first chapter number 2, that is the geometric design of highway. It is for 60 mark. In that, first is the definition of geometric design or highway design. It is the phase of highway design which deals with the visible elements of different highways, such as the alignment, side distance, etc., is called as a geometric design of highways. Now see, this is a point which can be remembered while geometric design of highways. First is, the alignment of highway should be economical, gradient must be easy and suitable, on side road provided adequate chamber, curves are smooth and easy, then keep each and every record of field work, and proper road signs must be provided. Remember these points while geometric design of highway. Now we can discuss the important highway terms. First is a right way. Now see, what is a right way? Right way means the actual area which can be required for the construction and development of road along its alignment is called as a right of way. That is the total area which can be required for the construction of roads. Now in this table we see the distance of right way. Now next point is factors which will be considered while designing the right way distance. First is the category of highway and width of roadway and road margins, then height of embankment or depth of cutting, then drainage system and its size, then sight distance, consideration on horizontal curves, and last is reserve land for future winding, that is a for future construction which the land which can be reserved. Then second is road margin. Now what is a road margin? The portion of land width on either side of road is road margin. Then next is roadway width. The top width of high embankment or bottom width of highway cutting excluding the side drains is called as a roadway width or formation width. This chart we had seen the roadway width. Then next is carriage way. What is carriage way? The portion of roadway constructed for movement of vehicular traffic is called as a carriage way pavement or crust. Hope you all get these four terms of highway. First is, what is first? Right of way. It is a first term. Then road margin. Then roadway width. And last is carriage way. Hope you all get these four terms in highway or in geometric design of highways. Now in next lecture we are seeing the next terms in the geometric design of highway. Now see, in this lecture you just get an idea about these all terms, and you will more understand these terms in the next part of chapter. Now just remember these terms and the meaning of these terms. Hope you all get these terms of geometric design of highways. Thank you.